When working with probabilities involving multiple random outcomes, it is important to understand the relationships between those outcomes. Two events are independent if one does not influence the outcome of the other. If you flip a coin and then roll a die, there's no reason to think that the outcome of the coin flip will impact the outcome of the die roll. However, if you deal two cards from a standard deck, the probabilities for the second card are influenced by the first card. If the first card is the Ace of Spades, then there's no way the second card could also be the Ace of Spades. We would call this dealing without replacement, and this is an example of dependent events. If we were to shuffle the ace back into the deck before dealing the second card, then the two events are now independent, and we call this dealing with replacement. We can use a probability tree to think about the nature of dependent and independent events. Suppose we have an urn that contains two blue balls and two red balls. Here are the probability trees for drawing with and without replacement. Notice that if we do not replace the ball, the probability trees for the second event are different. But if we do replace the ball, the probability trees are the same. The idea that some probabilities are connected to each other can sometimes play tricks on our brains. If you were flipping a coin and suddenly got heads four times in a row, you might feel that it's more likely that the next flip will be tails. Your intuition might be telling you that it's rare to see heads five times in a row, so you're due for a tails. Or your intuition might work the other way and you think you're on a hot streak. However, the reality of the next flip is that it is still a 50-50 proposition, just like every other coin flip. Another way of saying this is that sometimes our brain thinks that events are dependent even though they're not. This is known as the gambler's fallacy. We think that the probability of future events are impacted by previous events. In class, we will take a deeper look at dependent and independent events and use that experience to take a look at the non-intuitive result known as the birthday paradox.